गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल, आई एम सुप्रिया साळुंखे, लेक्चरर इन केबीपी पॉलिटेक्निक सातारा, गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑन विथ यू ऑन जनरल एंटरप्राइजिंग टेंडेंसी टेस्ट विच इज इंक्लूडेड इन अवर सिलेबस ऑफ सब्जेक्ट एंटरप्रीनरशिप डेवलपमेंट. सो हियर इज अवर प्रोग्राम नेम, इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग. प्रोग्राम कोड इज EE. कोर्स टाइटल इज एंटरप्रीनरशिप डेवलपमेंट. सेमिस्टर इज 5th एंड कोर्स कोड इज 22032. Now we are going to cover our course outcome, identify your entrepreneur traits, and our unit outcome, describe procedure to evaluate entrepreneur traits. So let's start with our test. So first, we know that entrepreneur is a person who wants to start his own business. So while starting his own business, he must have some skills or he must possess some traits that are, he must be innovative in nature, that he should be able to create his own idea related to his business. Okay, next, he must have ability to work in team. Okay, next, he must be courageous to take different risk, and he must have leadership qualities. So to find out that a particular person would possess these traits or not, this test is performed. So the test name is General Enterprising Tendency Test. So while going through this test, let's see some instruction related to this particular test. Here are some instructions. You merely required to agree or disagree with the statements that have been made. Okay, so you will get provide with some statements. Okay, so you have to decide whether you are agree with that statement or disagree with that statement. You also going to provide one answer sheet where you have to record that you are agree with that statement or disagree with that statement. So our next instruction is, on the answer sheet provided, you should circle A in the box which corresponds to statement number if you agree with that statement, and if you are disagree with that statement, then you have to circle D. If for any reason you neither fully agree nor fully disagree with a particular statement, please try to decide whether you agree with it or more or disagree with it more, and circle the appropriate answer. There are no right and wrong answer. You have to put your own opinion for that particular statement. So please be honest. Okay, so the answer sheet provided to you will be like this. So see, if you see in the answer sheet, you will have 1 to 54 statements. Okay, each block is different. Our first statement block is shaded and our 10th block is unshaded. So this is performed according to your statement nature. Okay, and these statements are classified in different rows. If you see, the horizontal lines are row 1 included the statements 1, 10, 19, 28, 37, and 46. Okay, up to row 9 there are statements 9, 18, 27, 36, 54, and 45. So after circling A or D, you have to calculate your evaluation or marks for particular row 1. So see, at the right side you get that 1 point for circling D in each shaded box. So if you see different blocks, there are 1 mark or 1 point for shaded box if you circle D there, and if you circle A in the shaded portion or unshaded portion, then you will get 1 point for that particular statement. Finally, you are going to calculate the score for each row. So for example, I will get 5 score for row 1. सो यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट टोटल स्कोर फॉर ईच रो. देन दैट स्कोर यू हैव टू पुट इन दिस टेबल. सो ही इन दिस टेबल देर आर फाइव सेक्शंस. सेक्शन वन इज रेफर टू रो वन प्लस रो सिक्स. सेक्शन टू इज रेफर टू रो थ्री. सेक्शन थ्री इज रेफर टू फाइव एंड एट. सेक्शन फोर इज रेफर टू टू एंड नाइन. एंड सेक्शन फाइव इज रेफर टू फोर एंड सेवन. सो आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग स्कोर फॉर ईच रो, यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट स्कोर फॉर ईच सेक्शन. सो फॉर वन सेक्शन यू विल एड रो वन स्कोर एंड रो सिक्स स्कोर. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई गेट टू स्कोर इन वन रो एंड थ्री स्कोर इन सिक्स रो. देन आई विल एड दिस टू स्कोर्स एंड आई विल गेट टोटल स्कोर फॉर सेक्शन वन दैट इज फाइव. देन आफ्टर कैलकुलेटिंग द स्कोर फॉर ईच सेक्शन यू विल गेट वॉट यू पजेस सम वॉट ट्रेड्स यू पजेस. ओके सो लेट्स सी. सेक्शन वन इज रिलेटेड टू need for achievement. So if individual who scores high in this section must have or must possess these following qualities or one of these qualities, so that person would be forward looking, self sufficient, optimistic rather than pessimistic, task or result oriented, restless and energetic, self confident, persistent and determined, and dedication to completing his own work. Next, if you get high score in your section 2, which is related to need for autonomy or independence, then that person must have qualities, likes doing unconventional things, prefers working alone, needs to do own thing, needs to express what he or she thinks, dislikes taking orders, likes to make up own mind, does not bow to group pressure, and is stubborn and determined. Okay, now, then average score for this section is 4. Section 3 is related to creative tendency. The individual who scores high is likely to have one of these qualities. He would be imaginative and innovative, has a tendency to daydream, is versatile and curious, has a lots of ideas, is intuitive and can guess well, and enjoys new challenges, likes novelty and changes. Section 4 is related to moderate or calculated risk taking. So the individual who scores high in this section must have following qualities that are: act on incomplete information, judge when incomplete data is sufficient, accurately assesses his or her own capabilities, be neither over nor under ambitious, evaluate likely benefit against likely to costs, set challenging but attainable goals. And section 5 is related drive and determination. The individual who scores high is likely to have many or if one of these following qualities that are: take advantage of opportunities, discount fate, make own luck, be self-confident, believe in controlling own destiny, equate result with effort, show considerable determination. So after calculating your total score for each section, you will get what traits you possess for being an entrepreneur. Thank you.